Okay, I have a feeling it's around time to switch back to the splat roller. Rotate. I think I did actually, I pretty much rotated. If you rotate and then you go diagonally and then down, it's a rotation. Since I didn't read this properly the first time, because you gotta read it with this amazing voice. Oh boy. So much energy. Anyway, the perfect weapon for getting up close and personal. Actually, maybe I did do that. I have a really bad memory. But maybe I didn't say it properly, completely. Because you press it with a midair and an arrow concentrated volley of ink. I don't know. I already have to go back and watch, like, a few seconds ago. Also, I just noticed something here. Look at the little loading symbol thing. I heard a rumor, for whatever reason, that Splatoon 2 is supposed to take place in the 90s. So, maybe, like, that would make sense, because that does make me think of Saved by the Bell. That thing, and you're just always thinking, when I wake up in the morning and I realize I'm an inkling, I like to spread ink everywhere. I don't know. We'll have to work on that one. It's not too bad, but it's not the best. Oh no, please, server, please don't quit on me now. I still have a few minutes left. I have... No. The other console is not responding. What do you mean, other console? I think that they're actually mean, like... That must mean the internet. But they just use that same sort of dialogue for the other console. Because of the fact that maybe that was just what they're using to when they're testing between multiple switches. Because if you have a Switch, you can have up to 8 Nintendo Switches, as far as I know, connected in one place. I think it's actually 10. If you have 4 on 4, and then you have 2 people spectating, so then you can do the proper MLG Pro kind of thing here. Also, I gotta count that guy's name. Silverhawk? There's no way you can do that with 10 letters. Because I can't spell my own name properly, because I only have 10 letters. It sucks. 3, 6... That is 10 letters exactly. Man. Still, if only Nintendo just allowed me to have 11 letters, I would very much appreciate it. Please, sir. Give me 11 letters. 10 letters just looks dumb. Glaciercano. Cano. Oh, I was gonna say canoe, which. Hey! That one jacket looks totally like. Well, it looks more 80s than 90s, I still think, but I don't know. 80s and 90s bleed over into each other a little bit. But also, I think that I figured out something about the splat roller. I think just to be able to nerf it a little bit more, they prevented... Yeah, it's you slow down whenever you just start going. So I don't like the nerfing. Because, yeah, you start off slow, I'm pretty sure. You have to build up momentum. And I can't really build up momentum as well as you might think, because... You have to constantly be wanting to get more ink, and I like to just ambush people with a roller, which doesn't really work so well, I guess, in this case. So, yeah, I very much appreciate... Actually, there are 3 maps. Lol. Oh no! I should have jump attacked, which I think I usually just did jump attack anyway on people for the most part. I'm gonna see if I can actually do this properly. Oh boy. Wait, they got rid of my special! No! Okay, whatever. Also, that just felt awkward, so I had to keep going. Oh no, please. Please, sir. Stop doing that missile thing. Now, what I'm gonna do here... Nope. Jump attack! Go! Yeah, that's right. Did it say ouch? I think so. But I'm going to be the best roller the world has ever seen. I can roll paint like one of those professional paintsmiths. That's what they're called. They're not called painters anymore. In this day and age, they are paintsmiths. Yeah. Oh no, the person's gone. He disappeared through time. I'm gonna be an awful person. Actually, oh no, they saw me. They know my secrets. Okay, time to run and just do more paint. Ambush. Yes, the only kind of bush that you will ever need in life. And am. Okay, well, I think this is not gonna work, but I can always hope that I'm gonna work through the pain and suffering of many. Actually, oh, I thought that was actually a person, but no, it was just a curling rock, not curling iron. slightly different of a thing. Okay, I probably should start looking around beside me and figure out where things are, where I am. Oh, no. No! My radius did not work so well. Okay. Come on, teammates. Balls. Okay, I had no teammates, and I was attacking three people. Where... I think that my team left, and they're a bunch of idiots. Okay, good to know. So, I get placed on the team that has never played Splatoon in their life. Which, I guess I shouldn't be complaining about, because this is the global test fire, and I'm, oh, that's just my luck always in life. Oh, boy. Come on, kitty cat, just roll yourself up in paint and... I just imagined... Zero, yeah, that's what I thought. We were two on four. That sucks, man. But two people actually did that well. Just think about that for a second. You guys are the real losers in life. We were the best. Two against four, we should have been completely annihilated, worse than that. But what I just imagine is somebody having a cat full of paint. You throw it at a wall, and it's like in the shape of a cat on a wall. It'd be awful, but I don't know why it makes me laugh. Animal cruelty, it's very funny. Trust me, it is. Whatever. But yeah, I guess this game is supposed to be like... I'm gonna say that the game is set in 1993. Because it's a good year. I don't know. Or we could go 91, because 91 is when... The Super Nintendo Entertainment System came out in 91. If I got my history correct. So... I think that that was probably the most radical of times, dude. And that's when... Like, so that one guy has an amazing coat. I want this coat in real life, like, really. It is delightful. But yeah, I guess people are now realizing... Yeah, this is definitely the team that I'm on. Are a team for Splatoon 1, pretty much. So, yeah, I kind of like the dualies, like, really, really a lot. The dualies are amazing. Okay, here we go. Time to already just kind of seek and destroy. I'm surprised that nobody actually tried to take me down. Like, hardcore. But then again, I guess nobody's using the sniper, because the sniper kind of... You know, every single time, it's me. The sniper in this game is still not desirable, always. No, please, please, no. I saved one of my teammates. Okay. I think that still this is a pretty overpowered kind of class kind of thing. Also, I keep forgetting that it's the jump button. It's kind of Dark Souls, but it's not at the same time because you have to be holding... Oh, no. You have to be holding down buttons, all crazy-like. Hey, you! Get out of here! I knew where he was, because he was spraying ink around the corner. Singing the CCR as usual. Ah, yes. Exactly what I wanted. Okay, so I might want to use my special right now, just to annoy them more so. Yeah, here we go. As soon as you see somebody that needs to be taken down to a level, and shown them that, you know what, they are not the boss of me now. Speaking... Well, actually, that's not really... I guess it started in the 90s, didn't it? Malcolm in the Middle? Or did it start in, like, 19... Actually, it probably started in 99. It probably did. Because it was early 2000s, pretty much. But yeah, this is basically like a shotgun, in a way. Which is probably why, like, these are going to be basically my favorite weapons. Oh, no. What happened there? I don't know, man. But, yeah... This is a skilled kind of gun, and I love it. Here we go. I need to take down this person right here, right now. No. That... Okay. Roller ability, more overpowered than mine? Not fair. Please nerf that one. That one in particular, and no other one other than that one. Because other ones are actually fun. Other than... I think... Which one was the one that I need to buff? I don't remember. It's difficult to think about it when actually you buff the guns that shoot from the sky, which I didn't actually use properly, I don't think, so I need to do that. But I think that these kind of dualies are more efficient, I want to say, with their inking. That's probably what it is more than anything else. So it's not like... I don't think that they're overpowered as much as just... Well, actually, they are. As much as they actually just straight up are. They're overpowered. Just look at that. How many dualies do we have? Dualies are the new roller. What? I don't know. We had more just, like, random splotches everywhere. Maybe if we all worked together and wore all of our salmon shirts together, we'd be able to do better. We still had one person that wasn't on our team. We had a like, number disadvantage, and yet, still, we almost pulled through. I'm still saying this is a matter of other people have played this game before or something. I don't know. Okay. I'm gonna go back to Splattershot once more, because I want to give the Cobra Commander more real testing. I need more consumer product testing on the thing. Then I can go do some more dualies, and hopefully I'll be able to get one more little bit of roller, which still they nerfed the roller into submission in this game, it really seems like. The roller is still good, but it's not like in the original Splatoon where it's just like, the roller's overpowered. Now it's the dualies are overpowered. Whatever's new and cool, whatever looks the coolest has to be overpowered. It's the law of Splatoon. There we go. I got it. I figured out the laws of Splatoon. But I wonder if people are just, like, leaving, or if we just, like, start a match without everybody in it. Or if it's just that a major problem of Salacious Crumb over here not helping us properly. And having internet connection problems. I don't know. Could be a problem. But yeah, I'm surprised I'm not finding matches instantly on this. Maybe nobody's playing at 9 o'clock at night in Mountain Time. Or if you're in Central, 10 o'clock. Or if you're in Eastern, 11 o'clock. Because we're just going across the clocks here. I really love the aesthetic of the game, though, with, like, 90s in quotation mark. Because it's still... It's hard to really determine an entire era just based off of color. I want to say, like, 80s were more known for coloration than... Ah, oh, come on! Why? Every single time! This is not fair! We've lost by default. Just want to let you guys know that. Also... Interesting! Okay, so you actually have, like, a proper, like, middle aimer in this. I didn't notice this the first time I was testing out this gun. But, yeah, we actually have a proper, like, middle aimer. So, you can tell exactly where you're firing. But yeah, I might as well just, like, ink up our area as best as possible. Now I target. Here we go. That, I think, is gonna do some good work. Yeah, so you basically have to be really, really far away to be able to launch an ICBM on the other team. So, something to note moving forward. Also, I'm just gonna stand up here and become a sprinkler. I don't know, a paint sprinkler would be a pretty, awful invention. I was gonna say good invention, but unless you're Mr. Bean, it's not a good invention. Not a good advention or invention. Okay, well, I'm gonna sit back here a little bit more. Keep spraying. Oh boy, that's essentially what, like, this game... Okay, here we go. I gotta get toward them. It actually makes more sense. Because now they're actually inking up our area. If they ink up our area, that's not good. Guy behind you. There we go. I didn't actually get to use my ability. No! Okay, if I go over here... Oh boy, people really didn't paint down our area. I guess it's because, like, my team... They're thinking since we have, like, nobody on our team, they're just like, yes, we need to work our best. There we go, gotta paint the vehicle. You can, I'll send you my invoice, I'll send you your invoice for that later. Okay, well, I gotta get out of here and do this. There we go. I think it's a matter of getting as many people as possible in that. There we go, that's some good, fun, Splatoon. Now you're thinking with Splatoonin, splatting all over people's faces. That's half the name of the game. Oh no. Yeah, I knew that there was, like, a guy, like, rubbing up next to me, but I didn't have anything that I could really do. There's nothing you can do, nothing you can do about it. Man, if I can't... I have to make one queen reference per episode. That's essentially the way things work. At least one. If not multiple. If not saying the entirety of Freddie Mercury's backstory of his life and his death. And whatnot. Here we go. Gotta use that as much as possible. It's a long range kind of special, which is actually not too bad. It's just... The special where you ground pound is obviously the best special because it's, you know, every single game has to have a ground pound. Well, we're gonna get destroyed. I'm surprised that wasn't 70%. Oh boy. So who's the one that was a quitter? You, Lewis. You have been revoked of the name Lewis. Your name is now Bob. Not as good of a name. I don't know. Maybe not. It's hard to say what's a good name and what's a bad name. Oh. Anyway, I gotta splat one more. I might actually be able to get a couple more matches out of this. Yeah, I'm gonna do my I'm gonna do splat dualies, because I need to do as many dualies as possible. Then I will end off maybe with a roller to feel awful. Oh boy. Because roller, if you have instant momentum change, good. If you don't, oh boy, Bromba. La la Bromba. I don't know, I really like that name. It's this one again. So I think, yeah, there must really just only be two maps, but it's just like the coloration schemes, like the design aspects of things, like, are very similar between the two that make me think, like, hey, this is exactly the same map. But actually having, like, the little things on the screen showing exactly where you're firing your ink is actually really good, I think. Because it shows the curves, you know? If you're actually on a curve, then it's just like, yes, please. Sugar. Okay. But yeah, like, this... I think this gun, well, these two guns, basically make the it makes the splatter shot a bit obsolete, I'd say, because this shoots more paint per second. It does more sexiness. There we go. He just throws down a curling rock. Nope. Okay, well, you're not gonna get into the Tim Hortons Brian like... Brian? Tim Hortons Briar like that. Or the Tim Hortons Brian. You're not gonna get inside that. Oh boy, I gotta paint a little bit farther forward, but I gotta use my special. That's the problem. I think that... Okay. Too much accuracy, not enough... Bland... Chrissy... I'm gonna go forward, because I need to paint this area a little bit more. And the vehicle. I think it actually does... Well... Can I actually destroy... Yeah, pretty much. Yeah. You're getting completely covered in our ink. Completely blackened. They should actually have that black ink. And to have the entire color... Well, it wouldn't be going blackface, but like... It... I don't know, somebody would probably find it racist in some way, and I don't know, It'd be a whole fiasco that would make Splatoon 2 more on the radar of people. And everybody would be like, hey, Splatoon 2, racist? Probably. Let's play this game. Well, you can't hit me, I'm in the air. That's actually, this is the counter. This really is the counter class to be, and the counterculture, most importantly. Speaking of 80s and 90s. No, please. Curling rocks are not... Okay, but it's still either way. It is essentially the counter to my curling. It's the roller counter, okay? There was 100% somebody there. He's just hiding in the corner. I don't know, like, how are there so many people that are really good at this game? It's just like nobody that hasn't played Splatoon hasn't played Splatoon. Everybody in the world's already played Splatoon. What's with this? Come on. There we go. Oh yeah, that's why. I haven't been using my ability to dodge properly. So I keep forgetting that's a thing. It's just like such a crazy ability that just doesn't... You don't think it's possible until you're dead. I completely rendered that roller ineffective. But they won. Like, look at this. Oh, it's so close. It's gonna be like 50-50. Oh, 44.5! Boom! Screw you people that played Splatoon for 2,000 hours and I only played it for like 5. And yet I still had the most amount of ink. That is how it's done! With Ike the Valkyrie. Okay, I'm gonna try to do some more rolling. The second half of the video, which I want to say that they're halves, probably. Actually, no, they're probably not halves. I'm really bad at math. Balls! Either way, I'm just gonna have as many... I'm still just gonna keep playing. I didn't do the... I should have done my math properly before I actually started recording this. But I didn't think ahead because of... Oh no, this is gonna be the last match I play. There's like exactly 3 minutes to 10 o'clock. Balls. Oh well. Hey, I had a good time with my, what do you call this? The Global Test Fire for Splatoon. It's a very good game, just like Splatoon 1. I'm very much excited to see more different kinds of maps, because still, they look too similar. It's just, there's something about it that just... They seem very, very similar between the two of them. It's not like Urchin Underpass... Is that the one? I don't know, there are two that were very, very crazy in Splatoon 1. No, you're not doing it right! But yeah, Splatoon 1 for the Global Test Fire had like crazy different maps. This one's... they have... very similar in the sense that you just like, you start off, you go down, you spin around, you realize that you're playing the same map like 5 times in a row, and it's just, it's hard to tell. They all look the same to me. I might be racist against these maps. And all these cartographers. Racist cartographers. Oh boy. Always so racist. I think that you need to spread more ink to be able to use this special than that one. Oh no. That special. Also, I guess that you use that special a lot faster. Like, well, that you just spread ink a lot faster with that. Because this has been nerfed. Like, 100% the roller's been nerfed. It's still a good weapon, but it's not as good as Splatoon 1's roller. Any of the rollers in Splatoon 1. Even the crap rollers of Splatoon 1, I'm pretty sure, are better than this. Which is, saying a lot, because I'm really bad. Hey! I think maybe... Oh, no. Yeah. I should have been able to get that kill. I was paranoid. What? That's not a saying that they're dead. Okay, here we go. Oh, good work. Maybe my team is the one to beat this time. I'm finally getting on to the people that played 2,000 hours of Splatoon 1. Or, in layman's terms, way too much time. I don't have time for playing video games, okay? That's why I always say, like, oh, these people play video games too much. Because I don't have the time. It's really sad. Okay. Oh, no. Roller. How did that person not kill me? Lol. Like, I did not deserve to live in that one. Like, really, I did not deserve it. But, hey. My team is taking over that area, so I'm going to go over to the right. See what I can do here. Hey, there you go. The roller is still really good at splashing people. Which is really weird considering that there's a momentum issue in this. So, if you don't have the momentum, it's... Oh, boy, it's a really weird conundrum. So you have to keep moving, but you don't... Oh, no! Okay, that ability is just way too good. Because there's no way of just, like, instantly stopping it. Because as soon as you see that, you're dead. GG. Okay. How did we not paint this area? We are not very good at painting walls. Still, not as good as Mr. Bean, as always. Mr. Bean is the greatest of painters in life. Well, this person needs to be taken down within, like, just a few seconds left. There you go. I just need to be more aware as being a roller. If I'm more aware of my surroundings, I think I can destroy people. But it was mostly my team that did that one. I did not help very much. But look at how amazing I look. Come on. I'm some sort of surfer dude. Or souffer. I'm a souffle. Look at that. Those hips don't lie. I eat a lot of souffles. I'm gonna continue just to hope that I can find another match, which I probably... Let's see if they actually break... if I can break the game right now. Oh boy. Because I'm gonna Halo 2 this thing. Maybe Nintendo doesn't realize. Maybe this isn't like the Testfire that was originally... Okay. At least I wasn't in the middle of a match. I'm fine with that. I'm gonna find out what more details. Checking server status. The server is operating normally. Oh no, what went wrong? But, yeah. I was hoping that I could Halo 2 this thing and just never leave. If you just keep playing, they can't turn off the servers. There's some sort of fundamental law of robotics that prevents me from not playing. Not playing. Oh boy. But I'd just like to say my thoughts. I might try to play a little bit more of the Testfire. I might not. It depends. I might just play on my own. Unless they have, like, new maps or something. Because, still, the people that have played this game, like... There's no way for me to actually compete with them. Like, legitimately, and destroy. And that's the only way that makes me feel good. Even if it's... The whole point of the game is just to cover area with paint. I still feel bad if I'm not, like, the best around. So it's just, like... At least in Halo, I can just, like, feel useful by, like, driving a warthog around in circles and do absolutely nothing. In this, I'm just like, if I'm not killing everyone and getting more paint than the world has ever known, more paint than that could cover the surface of the moon and make it really awkward and not being able to reflect light from the sun anymore. Unless you have some nice glossy paint, then it would still look kind of reflective. Then I'm just not doing well. So, that's my one problem. I definitely will enjoy the multiplayer once all the noobs come out to play when the game actually is released for full. And then I won't be able to play it like a month after the game's released, and I'll have to only play single player for the rest of my life. That's how my relationship goes with most multiplayer games. It's a very sad relationship, but it's a tender one, nonetheless. But yeah, still, it's a really good game. I really enjoy the... actually, the dualies, because they're actually really, really fun. As long as you remember that you can, like, dodge. The dualies, just in general, the amount of paint they cover is really good. But you gotta remember to be able to dodge. That makes it even more amazing. And one thing that I'd like to mention that they should actually have, which they don't in this game, which still it's a function of not having the gamepad. Having the gamepad, still, the Wii U was one of the best consoles of all time. Underappreciated. The most underrated console of all time. How about that, if nothing else? But, yeah, I can't actually play, like, Squid Jump between matches, which is very disappointing. I want to play Squid Jump. It was so much fun to play that between a match. It's just like, oh, man. I could be playing on my phone, but I'd rather be playing a real video game. A real fake video game inside of a video game. That's what they should do. They should release Squid Jump for, mobile, like iOS and Android. I'd buy it. Even if it was free, I'd buy it. I'd find a way. I'd send my money in an envelope over to Nintendo. Anyway, that's the one thing I'm really disappointed about. Other than that, still, it's a good continuation. They're adding new things. They're balancing things in ways that I might not agree with, which is usually what happens with a sequel of games, which is usually actually my problem with sequels. The first game is completely unbalanced, which I love them unbalanced pieces of garbage. Yeah! Okay. It's not that Splatoon 1 was a unbalanced piece of garbage, but it was unbalanced. Not garbage. Only paint. If you're throwing out paint cans, that kind of thing. It's toxic waste. That's what I'm saying. Anyway, I've been rambling on for a little bit here. But a very important kind of ramble on, just to give my impressions. I love the atmosphere, though. The single player of Splatoon 2 is probably going to be the best. Oh, it's going to be so good. So I'm really excited for that. Multiplayer I'm somewhat excited for, but I'm most excited for the single player of Splatoon 2. The multiplayer is still pretty good, though. Either way, still. I ramble. Either way, though, I might play a little bit more of this, or I might just play when the game is released. Definitely single player. I'll be recording it, though. Either way. Still, goodbye for now.